split phase motor is a type of single phase induction motor which has a main winding and a starting winding. The main winding has low resistance. The winding which is used in the main winding is such that it has low resistance and high reactance. Whereas the starting winding combined is such that it has high resistance but low reactance. The resistance of the starting winding can be increased by either connecting a high value resistance in series with it or by choosing a high resistance thin copper wire, because as the cross section of the copper wire reduces, the resistance of the same will increase. So, because of this change in resistance and reactance of the main winding and starting winding, as you can see in the phasor diagram, the current drawn by the starting winding, which is indicated by IS, lags behind the applied voltage by a small angle, whereas the current of the main winding indicated by IM lags with the applied voltage by a large angle. The phase angle between IS and IM is made as large as possible. The alpha must be as large as possible, because the torque of a split phase winding, split phase induction motor, is directly proportional to sine alpha. A centrifugal switch is connected in series with the winding and is located inside the motor. Its function is to automatically disconnect the winding from the supply when the motor reaches up to its 70 to 80% of speed. So at 70 to 80% of speed, the switch will be off. So in case where, suppose split phase motors are hermetically sealed, hermetic seal means completely airtight induction motor. Such motors are used in refrigeration unit. In these cases, the internally mounted centrifugal switch is not used, but an electromagnetic relay is used. As shown in this figure, the relay coil is connected in series with the main winding, and the pair of contacts are normally open. It is a normally open kind of relay, which is included in the starting winding. So this relay will operate on the starting winding, but it will be activated through the main winding. During the starting period, when the IM, the main winding current, is very large, the relay contacts are closed by the plunger action. This allows IS to flow. As this contact is closed, so starting winding will be connected to the circuit and the motor will start as usual. When the motor reaches 70 to 80% of the speed, IM value will drop, and so the current is not enough to keep the contacts closed, and so this will come in normally open position. Now here you can see a typical torque speed characteristic of such motor. The first curve indicated by dotted line here, this is the normal torque speed curve as we have learned in the theory of induction motor. And the second curve is also a different torque speed curve. Now, because of the two windings, the resultant curve which we get is the combination of these both curves. So, at any point of time here, the torque speed curve will trace this path as shown by the orange line. And from this point, it will run on this path. So during starting, we have some torque, and after the switch has opened, there is only one winding. So this curve is with only the main winding. And this curve is for resultant of both winding. So the actual curve as a combination of both this winding will be something like this. This is the torque speed curve of split phase induction motor. The starting torque, as you can see here, is 150 to 200 percentage of full load torque with a starting current of 6 to 8 times the full load current. Starting current is 6 to 8 times the full load current, IFN. These motors are often used in preference to costlier capacitor start motors. Typical applications are fans, blowers, centrifugal pumps, separators, washing machines, small machine tools like drill, etc., duplicating machines and domestic refrigerators, oil burners, etc. These are some of the most common applications. Usual speed range is 3450 rpm to 865 rpm. In this range, the motors are made, and it is available in 40 watt to 250 watt ratings. Now, as shown in this diagram, we can change the direction of rotation of such motors by reversing the connection of the running winding. Here you can see the running winding is connected in parallel with the starting winding. If you change the terminals of the running winding and starting winding, then these motors will run in the opposite direction. So, to make a motor reversible, the leads of both the windings are kept outside on the terminal box. So, by changing the connections of the two windings, we can make this motor to run in the opposite direction. Here it is running in clockwise direction, and when you reverse the connection, it will run in the anti-clockwise direction. These motors are having speed regulation very same as three-phase motors. Their speed only varies about 2 to 5% between no load to full load, which is very similar like a three-phase induction motor. And for this reason, such motors are usually regarded as practically constant speed motors. One more thing, sometimes such motors are also referred to as split phase motors and also resistance start motor, just to differentiate it with the different term, other term, which is known as capacitor start motor.